All right, so here's the deal. I didn't plan to make this video at all. I hadn't planned to make a video for the remainder of this week because I'm feeling a little under the weather right now. If you can hear it in my voice, I'm not feeling too well. I'm pretty lethargic, but my brain is not lethargic, okay? My brain always stays spinning, and so today it was spinning about the tornado in Clash Royale. Haha, no pun intended, right? And so I just have some thoughts about the tornado that I just want to talk about. So I just ask that you listen. If you have any opinions about what I say, leave a comment. So we're going to talk about the tornado, and I'll get some gameplay going for you guys. What replay? We'll watch this one, okay? So mainly what I was thinking about the tornado is that, you know, it's a card that has really always been relevant in Clash Royale ever since it was released. I believe it was released at some point in 2017, and pretty much no matter what reworks, buffs, nerfs, whatever Clash Royale has done to it, the tornado has always been a relevant card. And so I just kind of want to give my thoughts about this card because it is a pretty controversial card in the community. A lot of people love it, a lot of people hate it, a lot of people have no opinions about it. My opinion about it is that I like it as a card. I think it is a very unique card, but it has its flaws. So we're going to talk about some of those flaws. So I guess the biggest thing I want to talk about is that I don't really think the tornado can ever be a balanced card in this game. I legitimately do believe that. And so let me explain why I believe that. The biggest reason for that is because the tornado, it manipulates one of the core fundamentals in Clash Royale. And because of that, because it manipulates something that is so fundamental to Clash Royale and so fundamental to any video game, I don't think it really ever can be balanced. And so that thing that it manipulates, of course, is movement. Really, no matter the video game, it doesn't matter at all the video game, movement is pretty much a fundamental of all of these games. And the tornado in Clash Royale, it manipulates that fundamental because you can move cards around the arena pretty much wherever the tornado allows you to move it. And because of that, I just think it's natural that it is going to be an unbalanced card in Clash Royale. And really, when you look at all video games, I'm going to use Apex Legends as an example. Looking at Apex Legends, historically speaking, and even currently, the best legends in Apex Legends are those that can manipulate movement in the game. We look at legends like Horizon. By the way, I'm going to show gameplay of all these just so you guys can see my point. We have Horizon. She can manipulate movement. We have Octane, who can manipulate movement. Pathfinder can manipulate movement. And who was the last one I was going to use? Wraith. She can manipulate movement as well. And this is pretty much the case for all video games. I'm just using Apex Legends as an example. But the tornado falls under this category in which it can manipulate movement, inherently just making it broken, honestly. And also switching back to Clash Royale, we're going to look at some other cards that manipulate the core fundamentals of the game and show that these cards are broken and unbalanced as well. And the two main cards I want to look at are the Elixir Collector and the Elixir Golem. The fundamentals in Clash Royale that these two cards manipulate are the flow of Elixir. In the game's coding, these are things that are set at constant rates depending on your stage in a match. We have single elixir, double elixir, triple elixir. If it's the ramp up challenge, it can go up to 4 and 5 times elixir. And then we have 7 times elixir, of course, infinite elixir. And then in 2v2, the elixir rates are a little bit slower, but they're still set at constant rates per each game mode, per the time in the match. But the Elixir Collector and the Elixir Golem, they're just like, hey, what if we just take these things and what if we just manipulate them? The Elixir Collector just be like, hey, what if I just give you one extra elixir every so often? The Elixir Golem be like, hey, what if when I just die, I just give your opponent 4 elixir, you know? What if I were to just do that, you know? And so when you think about it conceptually, cards that do things like that are always bound to be broken. It just so happens to be that the Elixir Collector and the Elixir Golem are on the opposite ends of the spectrum, because the Tornado is good. Of course, the Elixir Collector and Elixir Golem aren't too hot right now, but that's because the Elixir Collector and Elixir Golem have been nerfed to the point where they are not able to manipulate the fundamentals of the game effectively. And so when your main purpose is to do that, you're pretty much always going to be unbalanced. In this case, Elixir Collector and Elixir Golem are bad because, like I said, they've been nerfed to the point where they can't do that and they're just totally out of the picture, but the Tornado is still good. I think I literally just reiterated pretty much what I said, but hopefully you guys understand what I'm saying. So I guess to conclude this point is that pretty much in video games across the board, entities in these video games that manipulate core fundamentals of the game, such as movement and such as the flow of things like Elixir, they are pretty much always going to be unbalanced. And of course, the Tornado falls under this category because it manipulates movement, and that is just going to make it naturally unbalanced, I think. Let's find another replay to watch. What do we want to watch? Let's pick something good. Here's a level one matchup. Let's watch this level one matchup, okay? So the next main point I want to talk about regarding the Tornado and how it's pretty much, you know, always going to be unbalanced is the sheer existence of splash damage cards. The way I see it is that as long as there are splash damaging cards in Clash Royale, which there always will be, there always has been, as long as these exist, the Tornado is always going to be relevant as well, and it's always going to be a good card. The way I see it is that the Tornado and splash damaging cards, they have a mutualistic symbiotic relationship. Now, those are some big words right there, but let me explain to you what that means. So a symbiotic relationship, for those of you that don't know, in biology, it's when two organisms, they basically kind of bond with each other in a way, not at the molecular level or not covalently, but they bond with each other, and either one or both benefit from the bonding. Like an example, if you've ever seen Venom, Venom is an alien symbiote who bonds with the host, and he ends up benefiting from that bonding. Mutualistic symbiotic relationships mean that both parties benefit. And in this case, with the Tornado and splash damaging cards, that is a reality. Let's use the Ice Wizard paired with the Tornado as an example. So the Ice Wizard on its own, it is a very solid card. There's no doubt about that in my mind. But if you pair that Ice Wizard with the Tornado on defense, that makes the Ice Wizard that much better. And also to go along with it, it makes the Tornado better. So by themselves, they are both good cards, but they both benefit from each other when they are paired with each other. It's a mutualistic symbiotic relationship. So this may have just been like a bunch of rambling to you. It honestly sounds like a bunch of rambling to me, but I'm still going to upload this to YouTube anyway, just because I thought I had some interesting thoughts about the Tornado, and I thought maybe you guys would be interested about them as well. So let me know if you guys like this format of video of me just talking about things relating to Clash Royale. It's not as highly edited as like my discussion video format, but I just have some thoughts. My brain is always constantly spinning. I think about a lot of things. And this is a scenario where I thought about something and I wanted to share it with you guys. Basically, the Tornado and just how its nature will always make it unbalanced. So if you enjoyed, leave a like, subscribe if you're new. I'll see you guys in the next video, okay? Peace out.